In this video, I'll show you how to create Instagram story ads that convert. According to Instagram, 400 million people use the app every day. And to capture the attention of this massive audience, I'll share my bootstrapping process for creating an eye-catching Instagram story ad without actually filming anything at all. I'll go through this process step by step on my phone and in my laptop so you can make an ad the exact same way. I'll also show you some important settings you'll need to adjust in Facebook Ads Manager when it comes time to launch your campaign. Ready to create your first Instagram story ad? Let's begin. Hey everyone, it's Jessica from Oberlo. Before I get started today, I want to make a little caveat. You're going to learn a lot about Instagram marketing today, but you won't learn everything you need to know about e-commerce success. That takes continuous learning. So subscribe to our YouTube channel to stay on top of the latest tips and trends for e-commerce entrepreneurs. All right, let's dive into Instagram story ads. When it comes to story ads, Instagram allows three ad formats. All of these appear in your audience's Instagram feed for 24 hours. The first format is a photo. That's a still image that will show up as a single story and will stay on your screen for up to 5 seconds. Here's an example of a photo ad from Skillshare. The second format is video. Video ads will show up as a single story and will play for up to 15 seconds. Here's a relaxing example of a video ad from the meditation app Calm. The third format is a carousel ad. Carousel ads contain up to 3 pieces of content that display as 3 stories. The content can be photos or videos. This ad format is best for story-driven content, like this ad from Gap. You can see that this ad actually contains 3 story videos that are stitched together as one ad. If you're dropshipping with Oberlo, you've already heard us talk about how video ads can help sell product. Because they convert so well, that's what we'll focus on today. By the way, if you're not dropshipping with Oberlo, definitely check out this video right here. With dropshipping, you can set up an online store and start selling products without carrying any inventory. That means a lot of your focus will shift to marketing tactics, like Instagram story ads. So let's get into the details of creating your first video ad. In the end, your ad will look something like this. Now from here on out, I'm going to switch in and out of my phone so that you can see me create the video live and follow along on your own phone if you'd like to. Before I got started, however, I made sure I had an image copy of my logo saved to my phone. Now that I have my logo saved to my phone, I'm going to look for product photos. And to do that, I'm just going to go right to my store on my phone. My dropshipping store is called Daybreak Leggings, and I sell leggings, as you can see here. So I'm going to scroll down and find the pair of leggings that I want to feature in an ad. I'm going to shop all leggings because the pair that I want is actually this marble leggings called Leah leggings. Right here. So I'll click there. And I love these product photos. I got all of these product photos from my supplier on Oberlo. And whenever you see great product photos on Oberlo, you're free to use those photos any way you'd like. And in this case, you can use them for Instagram story ads. What I want to do now is tap and hold these product photos and save them to my phone. And I'm going to do that for every one of these product photos, one by one. All right. Now, one important thing to note, I'm only running a story ad on one product. And there's a reason that I'm doing this. I want to make sure that I know whether customers like the Leah leggings or not. And if I run a story ad with multiple products in it, I won't know why they swiped up. I won't know if it's because they liked these leggings or if they liked another pair of leggings. And that means I'm missing crucial data that will help me scale ads in the future. So make sure when you're running Instagram story ads, or really any ad for that matter, you only do one product at a time and just run multiple ads for different products to see what works best. Okay, back to creating our ad. Now that these product photos are saved, I'm going to fire a photo editing app. I happen to like this app called InShot. And what I'm going to do is press video and press new. Now, when you go to photo, you can see all the different photos here that we can upload into InShot. Even though we're making a video, we're uploading photos into the app because essentially what we're going to do is create a GIF. So I uploaded one photo, and I'll go ahead and add the others one at a time. Now I want to move this around because I like the image of her twirling, but I'd kind of like her to be her front side to be showing first. So I'll move that to the beginning, and I'll actually move this next, and then her backside. Perfect. So now you can see if we play this or if we slide along it, the images change and she seems to be spinning. And I really like that. I'm also going to take this time to add my logo here. So I'll go ahead and upload that, and that will be at the very end. You want to make sure that you include your logo somewhere on your video ad so that customers know that they're seeing an ad, and they also know your brand if they're interested and they don't get a chance to click on your ad in that moment. Now, I want to make sure that this ad is formatted for Instagram. Right now, the photos all look like they're square. So to make sure that it's formatted for Instagram, I'm going to click Canvas. And then what you want to choose is 9:16 because that's the format for Instagram photo ads. I'm going to click the double check mark because then it will apply that canvas setting to all of the images that are in my video so far. So I'll click apply to all, and then we're good to go. Now it's formatted correctly, but if I actually hit play, you can see that it takes a long time for that first image to change. And that's not good. What you want to do is make sure you capture your audience's attention in the first second. They're so small, the attention spans on Instagram. And so to make sure I do that, I really want to make sure there's movement in that first second. But how do you make sure there's movement in the first second of a video ad that's comprised solely of photos? Well, you make those photos appear for a very short amount of time. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to go back into the phone and hit trim. Once we hit trim, I want this duration not to be for 5 seconds, but I actually want it to be for half of a second. And again, I'm going to click this double check mark to apply it to all the images. Now you can see that things change rather quickly, and she appears to even be spinning in the ad, which is exactly the effect I want. You actually have 15 seconds with an Instagram story ad. This ad right now is at 2.5 seconds. Just consider this a demo for that reason. If I were you, I would actually add maybe a whole new round of her spinning in place, for example, or some other, say, lifestyle shots of the product maybe being modeled by someone. But I'm just showing you how to put together these bare bone elements. You want to make sure the first second captures the attention of your audience, but then also make sure you use a little bit more than 2.5 seconds. Now I want to add some text to my ad. And so to do that, I'm going to go into my phone. I'm going to click that first image, and I'm going to click text, pretty intuitively enough. Now, it will probably take some fooling around on this app for you to get the hang of the keyboard. It's not so high functioning, but it does the job. I could write something like free shipping or anything else that I want to write. I can use this menu right here to change the alignment of the text. I can drag the size of the text to make it larger or smaller. I can also change the color of the text. I can change the color of the border, even the color behind the text. So a lot of functionality here. You can also change the font, and you can also change how the text transitions from one part of the ad to another. This is really something for you to play around with and find out what works best for your branding. But I do have a couple tips on what kind of text you want to include in an ad like this. A few notes on what text to include in your ads. The most important thing is to include a compelling offer. Just displaying your product images isn't going to be enough. You need to convince customers to buy your product now. For example, you might mention that shipping is free, inventory is limited, or that the item is on sale for a limited time. Just make sure that your call to action is repeated on your product page. So if on your Instagram story ad you say that a product is $19.99, make sure that it's $19.99 on your product page as well. Also, don't include too much text because remember that you've only got 1 second for your audience to pay attention. If they see a small novel, they're going to swipe away. And finally, pay attention to text placement. We want to draw attention away from the sponsored ad text that's in the upper left-hand corner of the Instagram story ad. So keep your text in the middle or even on the left or bottom of the canvas that you're working with. Now, do as I say, not as I do, because while I just gave you these tips for text, I'm actually going to be a little bit lazy in the demo and leave it at free shipping. After you've placed your text where you'd like, what you're going to do is press the check mark. You're going to press the check mark again, and then you'll want to make sure that this text appears for the whole time. So here you can see the green area is the text, and we just want to make sure that it aligns and it appears for the whole duration of the product photos, but it doesn't appear for this last logo that we show on the screen. So what you're going to do is drag this back so it ends right about there. This may take some fidgeting. I'll let you do that on your own, and I won't waste your time here in YouTube showing you how to do it. But now you know how to edit the placement of the text and the duration of the text in your ad. You're going to click the check mark, and let's just say that our ad is done right now. What we're going to do is click this button up at the top and save it. Now that it's saved on your phone, go ahead and upload it to your desktop, because it's going to be easier to work with this in your Facebook Ads Manager on your desktop. Yes, there is a mobile version of Ads Manager now, and that's great, but I still find that the functionality on the desktop is what I'm used to working with. It might be more intuitive for you too. So we're gonna switch into the desktop with a copy of our ad. So I'm in my Ads Manager, and I've actually gone through the whole process of setting a campaign objective and determining my audience and all of that. I'm not gonna cover all of that in this video, but I will in the future. So that's why it's important that you subscribe to make sure that you don't miss those videos when we get to those topics. What I wanna zoom in on for the purpose of this ad is the placement section. So if we jump into the laptop and go to placements, just make sure that you don't select automatic placements. Instead, select edit placements and deselect Facebook, deselect audience network, deselect Messenger, and deselect feed. You just want Instagram stories because this is an Instagram stories ad. After that, the next thing you want to focus on is actually the format. So the format you're going to choose is single image or video. And then the next step is simply to upload the video that you saved. Insert the product page as the website URL and select your call to action. I would select shop now because, of course, you're directing people to a dropshipping store. Because this is a stories ad, you don't need to worry about text, a headline, display link, or newsfeed link description. All right, this ad is a great start, but it's your own creative twist that will really make it stand out and get sales. So here's where I welcome your feedback. What would you change about this ad? Would you rewrite the copy, use a stronger call to action, choose different product images? Share your feedback in the comments and let's learn from each other. I'll jump into the discussion too. That's all for today. Remember to hit subscribe, and until I see you again, learn often, market better, and sell more.